Now, what a decade we have had in Formula One. Not only have we said goodbye to the V8s, but we've also had a whole host of incredible races, some of the best in Formula One history, and also some unbelievably amazing drivers and future superstars as well. Hi guys, my name is Aldas, and today I'm going to be going through my top 10 drivers of the decade as we draw a close to the 2010s and go into a brand new era with young drivers and new rules on the horizon. Nevertheless though, guys, do remember that this top 10 is my personal opinion, and I am very much looking forward to seeing what you think in the comments below. So don't forget to post at the end of the video your top 10 as well. But nevertheless, guys, let's get into it. Now, in 10th place, I have Sergio Perez. Now, I must admit, the 10th place was actually a tricky one to pick because people like Mark Webber, Felipe Massa, and Nico Hülkenberg were in the contention. But the reason why I decided to give it to Sergio Perez is that when you look at the decade as a whole and his longevity and what he's achieved in the past 10 years, I think it's just been absolutely incredible. Of course, he hasn't actually been in Formula One for 10 years. He started in 2011. But when you consider kind of the public perception that was around him when he came in as a paid driver, but what he's been able to achieve, the fact that he's been able to produce so many good results, he's been unbelievably consistent, and it's kind of a big shame that he never really had the chance at a proper top level driver. McLaren were in their downward spiral. But that doesn't take away from the fact that whatever team he's been in, he has just been incredible, really, and one of the most solid drivers of the decade. He'll nick the odd podium there and there, which is great for a midfield driver, and unlike some of his contemporaries like Romain Grosjean and Nico Hülkenberg, who we have seen a bit of a decline from both Romain and Nico, he is still in his prime, beating young talents like Esteban Ocon and Lance Stroll as well, and that just, coupled together with his talent as well, makes him one of the best drivers of the decade. Now, coming in at number 9, we have Valtteri Bottas. Now, he is actually a very interesting driver when you're talking about the best drivers of the decade, because, of course, over the past few years, up against Lewis Hamilton, which you kind of have to give a little bit of respect to the fact that he's up against one of the best drivers in Formula One ever, he hasn't quite been able to reach perhaps the heights that we thought he would. But in my opinion, that doesn't take away from the fact that I think a lot of people forget how good Valtteri Bottas really was, even in the early part of his career, starting all the way back in 2013 with a pretty poor Williams. So coming into that team as a rookie was never going to be easy, but what did he do? He made an impact straight away. He was better than his teammate Pastor Maldonado. He produced some outstanding performances in a very poor car, and then when Williams finally got their act together for 2014 during the brand new hybrid era, he absolutely dominated his experienced teammate Felipe Massa, and this is the period that a lot of people forget. This is where Valtteri Bottas really looked like an absolutely amazing young talent, perhaps even a future world champion, taking so many podiums with that really good Williams car and even challenging the likes of Ferrari and Red Bull. So it was no surprise when Mercedes called him up that he definitely deserved his seat. And yes, although he hasn't been at times the most consistent driver for Mercedes, and he hasn't quite been on that pinnacle of the current crop of drivers, there's no denying that he is a very solid driver. He never has a problem with anyone inside the team or any of the other drivers. He is just a very cool customer who gets in that car and just does the business. So yeah, Valtteri Bottas, he is in 9th. Next up, we have Daniel Ricciardo in 8th place. Now, what a driver and what a guy he is. I mean, first of all, his Formula One career, it's kind of crazy to think, and I think a lot of people forget, he started in 2011 with HRT, making his debut at the British Grand Prix in 2011. And the way he's risen up through Toro Rosso, and when he got into that Red Bull for 2014, we knew this guy was an absolutely phenomenal talent. His overtakes and the way he just kind of exploded onto the scene, beating at the first time of asking his four-time world champion teammate Sebastian Vettel, we knew he was something special, not only on track, but also his infectious personality and that smile, and just in general, his character off track as well. He is one of the nicest and most likable guys on the grid, but more than anything else, he is absolutely amazing on track. As I said, not only with his overtaking, but recently with his consistency and some of the just incredible results that he has been able to produce. Of course, I think the highlight of his career would have to be the 2018 Monaco Grand Prix. Not only getting pole position, but then also the race win as well. Redemption from a few years back when it was basically stolen away from him, from his team. He has shown to be one of the grittiest drivers on the grid. And also his mental strength as well is just unbelievable. Up against Max Verstappen with all the hype around him and everything along with that, he was the guy that actually went toe-to-toe with Max and proved that given the same car, these two are a very good match. And I think he has a lot of unfinished business left in Formula One. This guy is a championship winning caliber driver. Mark my words, if he is given a good enough car in the future, as I said, I think he has some serious unfinished business in Formula One. And I do believe that this guy could be a future world champion. Now, next up in number 7, I have Jenson Button, and what a special driver he was. In terms of off the track, he was such an amazing person, always so funny, and just seemed like one of the nicest guys on the grid. And I mean, in terms of on the track, there's no doubt that he was in his prime in the early 2010s before tailing off a little bit, and then of course retiring in 2016. A very emotional retirement that I think was felt throughout all of the paddock, because he is just such an iconic driver, an incredible talent, a 2009 world champion. But he is one of the very best of all time. I mean, in terms of wet weather drivers, I don't think there's very many that are much better than Jenson Button. There is only a few, because he is one of the very best in terms of the changeable conditions and gave us the greatest race, in my opinion, of all time with the 2011 Canadian Grand Prix, a career-defining race of just resilience, never giving up, and in the end, winning it on the final lap of the race during a Grand Prix that lasted, I think, like 4 hours long. And of course, it was in changeable and wet weather conditions that turned into dry, and it just defined his career. In his prime in the early 2010s, he was up against the likes of Lewis Hamilton, Fernando Alonso, Sebastian Vettel, Mark Webber, legendary drivers, and he could battle them all, and on his day was one of the very, very best, and undeniably an iconic driver, a driver that I really do miss. And yeah, Jenson Button in 7th place, and what a career this man had. Now, coming in at number 6, I have Max Verstappen. Now, the interesting thing about Max is, of course, he started in 2015 and has only been around for half a decade. So, obviously, in the conversation of the top 10 drivers of the decade, perhaps that might go against him. However, this man is something special. This man was a phenomenon that reinvigorated Formula One and will change Formula One for the next 10, 15 years. This guy could very well go down at the end of his career if he makes the right moves and achieves to his true potential. He could go down as arguably the greatest of all time. But of course, that's a conversation for a whole other video. But the reason why Max is on this list is because I've just never seen a driver like him for his age. I mean, number one, except from his unbelievable raw speed, obviously. At the moment, he's the only man that can challenge Lewis Hamilton over the course of a season in terms of consistency for a title if he's given a good enough car. And then you get to his wet weather capabilities as well, that Brazilian Grand Prix in 2016, and then some of the overtakes that he's been able to pull off. Except from all of those things, how influential this man has been by himself in his early 20s. He's able to sell out grandstands, and by himself, he is the reason why we are going back to the Netherlands, going back to Zandvoort, and to have that sort of influence and power at such a young age to sort of go along with the talent. It's something that I never thought I'd see, and it's honestly a testament to how good this man is, and he is not even in his prime. It's honestly scary to think how good this guy can get and what he can achieve in the future, and that is why he undoubtedly deserves a spot as one of the greatest drivers of this decade. So we're into the top 5, and in 5th place I have Kimi Raikkonen. Now, his longevity has been the most impressive thing about him. There's no doubt that he does still have speed, and even given the fact that he's 40 years old, his longevity in Formula 1 has been phenomenal. He is going into his 3rd decade in this sport and has actually been in Formula 1 for almost half his life, and yet he is still performing at such a high level. When you look at what he's done over the past decade, of course he came back in 2012 after having a few years out to do some NASCAR and some rallying, but even then with Lotus Renault at the time, he was still a very good driver. Yes, he's not in his prime at the moment, but when you look at what he's done in Formula One in this past 10 years, I think he has still been one of the most outstanding drivers. Of course, getting that call back up to Ferrari and doing such a solid job all the time. Yes, he was not quite up there with the Fernando Alonso's and the Sebastian Vettel's, but that doesn't detract from the fact that he has been a very consistent driver, perhaps not championship quality anymore, but a very solid pair of hands as well. And now at Alfa Romeo, where he has just no pressure at all, he just thrives as being the team leader and just enjoys Formula One so much. And there's no doubt that he has been one of the very best drivers, not just over the past 10 years, but also one of the very best drivers in Formula One ever. And it will be a very, very sad day when Kimi Raikkonen does decide to leave Formula One. But for now, the old man is still here and we absolutely love him. So yeah, Kimi Raikkonen, he is in 5th. Now, next up in 4th place, I have Nico Rosberg, and a very interesting driver to talk about, because off track, he was actually a little bit of a love-hate kind of guy, because there was so much hate towards him that I just never understood. He was, to me, he was actually a very nice guy, But on track, in my opinion, this guy is one of the most underrated drivers of all time. Certainly the most underrated driver on this list, because I think people only now are starting to realize just how good Nico Rosberg was. At his time, he was so underappreciated. First of all, in his kind of younger days against Michael Schumacher, there was always the argument that Schumacher was way past his prime. So Nico Rosberg, you know, what he's doing is not that special. But when you actually looked at the individual performances, the fact that he managed to always outperform Michael Schumacher and kind of grab the odd podium there and there, and then his first ever win in 2012, I mean, that just shows that he had talent from a young age. And then up against Lewis Hamilton in their very famous rivalry, he gave Lewis Hamilton a good run for his money and pushed Lewis harder than any of his teammates had ever done before, to the point where Lewis had to elevate his game. And then when Nico actually retired in 2016, that is the reason why we are seeing such a dominant Lewis Hamilton now. I suppose, as good of a driver as he was, the big what if and the only thing that I kind of hold against him is that he did retire so early after 2016, because if he didn't, could he have won more world championships, maybe in 2017, 18 or 19? We're just never going to know. And that's kind of the big what if with Nico Rosberg. But nevertheless, he was still a fantastic driver and someone that on his day was up there with the very best. So we are now into the top three, and in third place, I have Sebastian Vettel. Now, let's get to kind of the really big kind of elephant in the room with Sebastian Vettel. There's no doubt that over the past couple of years, he hasn't been the same consistent driver that perhaps he was at the start of the decade, and he wasn't able to elevate his game up to the kind of the levels of Lewis Hamilton. And although he did put in a decent title kind of challenge in 2017 and in 2018, he wasn't able to sustain it throughout the entire season. And now in 2019, we have seen him kind of again suffer with kind of almost the same issues of struggling in wheel-to-wheel combat, making mistakes, and now getting beaten by his teammate Charles Leclerc. However, once again, that doesn't take away from the fact that this guy is a four-time world champion. The way he began this decade, I honestly, it was unbelievable to watch him. The sort of magic that he could produce in that Red Bull, the way he was winning races from pole and just blasting away into almost a whole different universe compared to the rest of the grid, going for fastest laps when he didn't even need to, getting almost held back by his own team because of how quick he was. And always, all people were talking about was just how good the cars were and that Sebastian Vettel was like overrated. But the truth is, his teammate was never finishing second alongside him. It wasn't like Lewis Hamilton and Nico Rosberg level of dominance. I think it was honestly just because people just did not like Sebastian Vettel yet again. But to me, yes, he does have his demons. He is not a perfect guy. He is not a perfect driver, but that will never take away from the fact that he is a four-time world champion and a Formula One legend. Now, coming in at second place as the second best driver of the decade, in my opinion, Fernando Alonso. And what a frustrating guy he is, because to me, on a talent level, he's comparable to Lewis Hamilton, Senna, Schumacher, Jim Clark, whatever. Put them all in the same car, and I think the aggressiveness and the pure and utter talent of Fernando Alonso will shine, and there's no doubt about that. We have seen so much of that. He has been one of the most consistent drivers just ever, even in his later years in the McLaren. I mean, completely kind of whitewashing Stoffel Van Dorn in his final year, and always outperforming those horrible McLaren cars, and even what he managed to do in the Ferraris in the early 2010s, I always thought he was a better driver than Sebastian Vettel. And that 2012 Ferrari season, I think, was honestly his absolute best. I felt so sorry for him not getting the title. However, I've always had this saying with Fernando, and it's good drivers in Formula One will always find their way into good cars eventually. Fernando Alonso is an incredible driver who always found his way out of good cars, and that is the biggest what if with Fernando. To me, his legacy will always be as one of the greatest drivers in Formula One history, and certainly one of the greatest of this decade. But alongside that is clearly a person and a driver who has a bit of a toxic kind of character that burns bridges and burns relationships within teams, and that is what we've seen. What could have happened if he stayed with McLaren with Lewis Hamilton in 2008? What could have happened if he stayed at Ferrari and perhaps been against Lewis Hamilton in 2017 and in 2018? We're never gonna know, because this man, alongside a phenomenal driver, he's a bit of a double-edged sword, but that does never take away from the fact that this guy, in my opinion, is still one of the very, very best. And finally, we get to my number one driver, the greatest driver of the decade, and that is, of course, Lewis Hamilton. Now, aside from all the stats, all the achievements, the fact that he's not only a great driver on track and all the skills that he has, the overtaking, the wet weather capability, the consistency, the qualifying, it's kind of phenomenal that we have a driver like him. And he is such an incredible benchmark as well for these guys to go up against, because as good as all of them are, and as much as they will improve, and as much as their teams need to improve as well, because him and Mercedes is a formidable partnership, he has still won the past three championships with like three or four races to go. And that is seriously impressive, because that still means that these drivers have a long way to go to actually being able to put this guy under pressure and make him make mistakes and actually take a title away from him. So that is going to be kind of the really interesting story. Who is going to be that one guy and that one team that can put everything together to take Lewis Hamilton off his throne? For the past 10 years, he has just been a solid driver, improving all the time. And as I said, losing to Nico Rosberg, I think, was actually one of the most biggest things that ever happened to him, because it almost made him better to a point where he is now, no doubt, on kind of like the Formula One Mount Rushmore of the greatest drivers of all time. He has been the most consistent, the most solid, and the legacy that he's going to leave when he leaves Formula One, and the records that he is going to leave when he leaves Formula One, well, who's going to break them? Because that is going to be the really big question. Who is going to be the next Lewis Hamilton? Well, guys, there you go. That is my list of the top 10 greatest drivers of this decade. Of course, the big question is, who is going to be on the list in 10 years' time? Who are going to be the next top 10 greatest drivers of the next decade? There's no doubt that we have been blessed with some incredible drivers over the past 10 years and some amazing performances, some legends in the making, and certainly some young drivers that I'm very much looking forward to seeing where they are going to go and what they're going to be able to achieve. Now, as I said at the start, let me know your top 10 in the comments below, and I hope you did enjoy this video. Now, don't forget, if you want to support the channel, then drop a like, smash that subscribe button as well, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.